Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced series. In today's lecture, we will talk about ViewChild and ContentChild. First, let's explore ViewChild. ViewChild is a decorator in Angular that enables you to directly access a child component or a DOM element within a parent component. This is particularly useful when you need to interact with the child components, such as calling a child component's method. This is our existing ViewStudent component in which we pass input and output decorator. But by using ViewChild, we can pass student without input decorator. So I'm going to remove this input decorator, and then I have to remove this property from the parent component. Okay, now after removing our input decorator and this property, now how can we pass student dynamically? Now in app.component.ts file, I'm going to add a decorator @ViewChild, and in this decorator we need to pass few parameters. The first parameter we need to pass is the component name. Here I'm going to add ViewStudent component. Second, we need to pass static true, and static true means I can access it in ng on init. Then we need to define its name and provide its type, which will be ViewStudent component. To resolve this error, we need to define it not null. Now as static is true, so I can define it in ngOnInit function, and this dot ViewStudent dot, now I'm getting all the function which we have in our ViewStudent component, dot student is equal to this dot student. Now by this ViewChild, we can pass the dynamic student value to the student of the ViewStudent component. As you can see, there is no change on the output, we just change the internal approach. And now we're passing dynamic student by ViewChild rather than input decorator. As I have already mentioned that we can define static true or false in ViewChild. But when we define static true, then child is available in ngOnInit lifecycle hook. But in case of false, the child is available in ng after viewInit lifecycle hook, and it is default behavior. Next we have ContentChild. ContentChild is a feature in Angular that enables you to access content that has been projected or passed into a child component from a parent component. The content is inserted into the child component using a special placeholder called ngContent, which acts as a slot for the projected content. For ContentChild example, we will use our ViewStudent component, and here I'm going to add ngContent tag before our student. Now ng content we pass from parent. In app.component.html file, under this app view student tag, I'm going to add div, and in this div I'm going to write h1 tag. This is content child, and now I will refresh it to see the result on the front end. So our h1 tag is displayed. This is content child. But if I want to add more than one content child, then I will add the selector in ngContent tag. And here I'm going to add two selectors. One is title and second is subtitle. Now we access it from our app.component.html file. Now for binding the selector, I will write the name of that selector in this div. And in subtitle div, I'm going to have h6 tag. So content child is a parameter decorator that is used to fetch the query list of elements or directive from the content DOM. Now let's run the application and see the result on the front end. And here we have one title and two subtitles that bind it with the content child. This is the way we can pass dynamic data from parent component to the child component by content child. Now if we compare both the content child and view child, then view child is used for accessing child components or DOM elements directly within a parent component's template, while content child is used for accessing projected content passed into a child component from the parent component. So this is it for today. Hope you understand it. If you have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But if this lecture is helpful for you, then guys, please like, subscribe and share my channel. Thanks for watching.